Good morning. Today is May 17th, 2020, sixth Sunday of Easter. And on behalf of St. Juliana Falconeri Catholic Church in Fullerton, California, we welcome you and we thank you for joining us this morning. The Mass readings today can be found at usccb.org. You can also find the readings linked at our parish website, stjulianachurch.org. We invite you to participate prayerfully this morning as Father Michael Pontarelli celebrates the Mass.
Give glory to God in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, his Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all and with your spirit. We've gathered together to give glory and praise to God this sixth Sunday of Easter. Let us remember the way that we've known, loved, and served God in this life and give thanks for the times we've turned away from our salvation. We ask pardon and redirection to the source of everlasting life.
You are sent to heal the contrite of heart, Kyrie eleison.
On us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, so people of good will. We
us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that we may celebrate with heartfelt devotion these days of joy, which we keep in honor of the risen Lord, and that what we relive in remembrance, we may always hold to in what we do. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Philip went down to the city of Samaria and proclaimed the Christ to them. With one accord, the crowds paid attention to what was said by Philip. When they heard it and saw the signs he was doing, for unclean spirits crying out in a loud voice came out of many possessed people, and many paralyzed or crippled people were cured. There was great joy in that city. Now, when the apostles in Jerusalem heard that Samaria had accepted the word of God, they sent them Peter and John, who went down and prayed for them, that they might receive the Holy Spirit, or had not yet fallen upon any of them. They had only been baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. Then they laid hands upon them, and they received the Holy Spirit. The word of the Lord. Praise be to God.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. Shout joyfully to God, all the earth. Sing praise to the glory of his name. Proclaim his glorious praise. Say to God, how tremendous are your deeds. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. Let all on earth worship and sing praise to him. Sing praise to your name. Come and see the works of God, his tremendous deeds among the children of Adam. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. He has changed the sea into dry land. Through the rivers they passed on foot. Therefore let us rejoice in him. He rules by his might forever. Let all the earth cry up to God with joy. Hear now, all you who fear God.
why declare what he has done for me. Blessed be God who refused me not. My prayer are my kindness. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul, Peter. Beloved, sanctify Christ as your Lord in your hearts. Always be ready to give an explanation to anyone who asks for you for a reason for your hope. But do it with gentleness and reverence, keeping your conscience clear, so that when you are maligned, those who defame your good conduct in Christ may themselves be put to shame. For it is better to suffer for doing good, if that be the will of God, than for doing evil. For Christ also suffered for sins once, the righteous for the sake of the unrighteous, that he might lead you to God. Put to death in the flesh, who is brought to life in the Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you and with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. Glory to you, O Lord. Be in my mind and my lips and in my heart. Jesus said to his disciples, "If you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you always, the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot accept, because it neither sees nor knows him. But you know him, because he remains with you and he will be in you. I will not leave you orphans. I will come back to you. In a little while, the world will no longer see me, but you will see me, because I live and you will live. On that day, you will realize that I am in the Father, and you are in me and I in you. Whoever has my commandments and observes them is the one who loves me, and whoever loves me will be loved by my Father, and I will love him and reveal myself to him." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Have you ever noticed that if you take a stick and throw it, and it comes back to you, you have a boomerang? But if you take a stick and throw it, and it just goes away, you've got a stick. You'll laugh at 11. Here's the point. A lot of times, teachings come back to us. They come back to us because they're important and they guide us. they come back to us because they really are the truth. And the truth is necessary for life. It sets us free, free from ignorance, and allows us to go on and live as human beings, always aware of our surroundings and knowing the greater things. That's what makes us a whole lot different from rocks, from carrots, and dogs. We want to know the truth. The truth sets us free. We want to relive the experiences of truth. We know this from the beginning when we start school. You know, when I was a young cadet recruit at St. Catherine's Military School, probably my boot camp year, we had little books called Think and Do. Maybe you had them in your schools too. But at Anaheim's Little Army, I can't remember what Think and Do taught, but I remember the title, Think and Do, because whether it was any one of the teachers or the military men or my own parents, I was taught, why don't you think, then do? And so why don't we think and then do? These are the qualities of the good Christian. Comes back to haunt me in the story of Martha and Mary. Martha is busy doing, and she's quite upset. She becomes impatient. She becomes furious because she's simply doing. But Mary is able to stop and think, to be taught by the best of all teachers ever, the Lord Jesus. And that's important for our faith, to be taught the faith. In the Acts of the Apostles, Peter goes down to proclaim Christ to the people of Samaria. The Samaritans didn't have much time for Christ, but he's teaching them so that they will know about Jesus. In the letter to St. Peter, sanctify Christ as Lord in your hearts. Always be ready to give an explanation to anyone who asks you for the reason of your hope. You have to be taught something about Christ. And then in the gospel, the Holy Spirit will come and be with us always and teach us the truth. If I can convince my congregation and anyone who wants to listen to me about Christianity, it's religious conversion that's essential. Conversion of the mind to know. Conversion of the heart to feel, to have empathy, to have human understanding one with another that comes not from the mind but from the heart. And then going out and doing the moral quality, the moral action. Remember, Martha is all about doing, and Mary was busy being taught, and Jesus sort of provided the heart of that afternoon, didn't he? Back to St. Catherine's. The Dominican sisters, their motto of the organization of the order, Dominicans, is Veritas, and it was right above the altar. What a more appropriate place to put it than above what is truth, the altar itself. That truth that says Jesus is Lord, that truth that proclaims the mystery of the faith, Jesus is Lord. Do we know that? Do we say really with any understanding, I believe in one God, I believe in Jesus Christ, I believe in the Holy Spirit, credo to each of those, I credo, I believe in God the Father, I credo, I believe in Jesus Christ, I credo, I believe in the Holy Spirit. Is it really part of our understanding? If it were, then certainly there would be no doubt that Jesus is present in the Holy Eucharist. There would be no doubt that God is the creator of all life, and so it's sacred, and so we can't take it for granted. And we have to be patient when people tell us that there's a pandemic, and it's spreading from place to place, and it causes death. Maybe where we live, only a few, but how much death does it have to cause before it becomes serious? If we're really people of life, we are people who cannot stand death that's caused by some kind of action that could be prevented, whether it's abortion or acting recklessly in time of pandemic. We really believe that God is the author of life, We'll take care of creation, as Pope Francis tells us in his encyclical Laudato Si. We'll be people like St. Francis. We'll be people like Jesus Christ. We'll be good Christians. The neighbor next door, you hope, is simply a good person. Doesn't have to be a good Christian. But you don't want that neighbor next door to do anything that's in violation of human rights and liberties. You want that person to be respectful of human life. We Christians are respectful of human life because God is respectful of human life. We go out and do our moral actions in imitation of Christ Jesus. That's why we're moral. Not because we want to be just simply good people, not because we want to be Eagle Scouts or notable people in society, but because we are Christians. What we do for the love of God. Think. What is it that you understand about God? What is it that you understand about Jesus? What is it that you understand about the Holy Spirit? What is it that you understand about the Roman Catholic Church? In the understanding. And then, how do you do God's work, Opus Dei? How do you do Christ's work? How do you do the gifts of the Holy Spirit, wisdom and understanding, fortitude and patience, all of those gifts that he gives us, so that we can have a connection in our heart with Almighty God and with everyone else? When that stick comes back, that boomerang, sort of hits you in the face sometime if you're not careful. Allow the readings this week to come back and strike you in the face and say, I've got to spend some time knowing the faith better so that I can serve God and neighbor better. I've got to spend some time with the faith loving Jesus, loving God the Father, loving the Holy Spirit, so that I can do the works of love better. Jesus tells us that if we keep his commands, he'll know that we love him, and everyone else will know that we love him as well, and he'll reveal himself to us. He tells us that he's going away, but stay patient. He's coming back, and when he comes back, we'll experience him as he wants us to experience him, renewed. Use this time of house arrest to renew your faith, to be church on retreat. It's worse than Lent, I understand. There's no fish fry on Fridays when we sort of eat fish and drink liquor and join with the community called church. But use this time to renew your faith, to be converted to Almighty God in the mind, in the heart, and in the action, to know, love, and serve God. You know, that stick came back. I learned that as a young cadet, and I suppose all of us did somewhere along the way. Sometimes we need to use that knowledge that we learned. I learned an awful lot of things. We all did. Quadratic equation. Can't remember when I used it last. Boyle's gas law. PV equals NRT. I don't even know why I remember it. But it served me at the time. Conversion will serve us all the time. May the neighbors know that there's a Catholic Christian from St. Juliana, or a parish of the Diocese of Orange, or any parish of the Church Universal living next door to them. Remain in God's love, for he remains with us. Do God's love, for that's what we were created to do, to have life and life in abundance. God bless. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, and through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Knowing that God is truth, and the truth will set us free, by living the commandment of Jesus to love one another, we make these petitions to our Heavenly Father today.
For the Church, formed in the Spirit as the body of Christ, may God graciously grant us what we need as we proclaim the good news. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, may the good news of the gospel guide their actions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, especially those who feel alone in their struggle, may they experience the comfort of our loving God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For scientists, health professionals, public officials, and all who serve the common good in this difficult and uncertain time, that they may be filled with wisdom and understanding. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For mothers, as we continue our Mother's Day novena, and for Nicholas Gasolone, Nancy Austin, Frank Gomez, and Glendora Kofer, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Good and gracious God, we ask that you come near to us today and always. Guide us to know, love, and serve you in this life, so we'll be happy with you in the next. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord, today and forever. Amen.
Where there is injury.
table is ready now. Pray that my sacrifice and yours may be found acceptable to God, the Almighty and loving Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice from my hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, so that, purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and forever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer to you, O Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Kevin, our Bishop, his brother bishops, and all who minister in your name. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your great mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, Would Saints Juliana, Peregrine, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. At Jesus' command, and using the very words he taught us, together we pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, O Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that, by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. O Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always and with your spirit. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the table of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should come under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The body and blood of Christ continue to bring me to everlasting life. Amen.
Let us pray in an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Still.
A prayer to Christ crucified in time of pestilence and contagion. Dear Lord Jesus, Savior of the world, our secure and unfailing hope, have mercy on us and deliver us from every evil. We beg you to overcome the scourge of this fearful virus which is spreading from place to place. We beg you to heal the sick, to protect the healthy, and to support those who work for the health care of all. Show us your face of mercy, O Lord, and save us in your great love. With the intercession of Holy Mary, your mother and ours, ever close to us in our needs, we ask you this, Lord Jesus, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen.
Hello, St. Juliana. For those who don't know me, my name is Garrett Gamboa. I am the coordinator of youth ministry and confirmation of the parish. Attention high school and college graduates. We would love to celebrate you with a Mass next Sunday, May 24th at 9 a.m. On this day, we will be showing a slideshow before and after Mass to honor you. Please email your pictures, first and last name, and school you're graduating from by this Thursday, May 21st. High school graduates, please email me at garrick.gamboa@stjulianachurch.org. College graduates, send your information and pictures to Jessica at jessica.martinez@focus.org. And don't worry, if you didn't get that, you can look at the slide after Mass following this. Thank you, and we as a parish are looking forward to celebrating with you.
I'd like to especially thank Garrick, for he's the one who prepared the confirmation candidates for the sacrament of confirmation, which they would have received last Wednesday. It was kind of a fun day last Wednesday in a number of ways for me personally. My 38th ordination of priesthood was the May 8th. I guess that was maybe Saturday or Friday, whenever it was. Anyway, Bishop Vam sends ordination cards to his priests at their anniversary, and mine came on Wednesday the 15th, which would have been the confirmation day. And it was a picture of the pelican in the front of the altar on the card, which means that he picked it out specially. And I sent him a little message, a video text message, thanking him for that card and for the, especially the picture of the pelican. It made it all that more personal. And I told him how sorry I was that he wouldn't be here for confirmation, because we'd have dinner together. I missed him that day. I want you to know that Bishop Vann and the bishops of California are in fact working diligently with the governor's office, Governor Newsom, through the Bishop of Sacramento, Bishop Jaime Soto, who's really a native of the Diocese of Orange, to reopen our churches. It's not that we're not doing nothing. It's that we are in line for what is being done as we pray for the supporting those who work for the health care of all. I've gotten a couple of letters, emails, and texts, all written in capitals, which is like being shouted at, and certainly at least one telephone call during the week to say that we are doing nothing. That's not the case at all. And to liken the beaches being open but not the church being open, those are two entirely different venues. The park across the street is open, but the schools, the two of them on this property and the public school across the street, remain closed. And when we do reopen, we're going to be a bit different. I want just simply patience for all of us, myself included, because I'm becoming impatient, and you all are. And I want to thank those who serve our parish, starting with Garrick. He too was disappointed that there was no confirmation. And our school, with Mr. Gonzalez and Mrs. Donnelly, and especially the eighth graders and their parents, they're disappointed because there's not the graduation that they wanted. But it's the graduation they're going to have, simply because we are patient. Remember, Martha became impatient and was distracted from the ways of the Lord. Mary remained patient, listening to the Lord and growing in his love. Listen to the Lord, grow in his love today and always. God bless. And let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, you restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ. Increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this Paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of his saving food. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. Our celebration is ended. Let us go and glorify the Lord by the way we live our lives. Thanks be to God.